Welcome back to my YouTube channel. I'm Bolanga Adedulu. If you are here to subscribe to my channel, please subscribe, like, and also comment. In today's tutorial, I want to teach you how to cut peplum cloth. We have different kinds of peplum cloth. We have flat peplum cloth. We have pretty peplum cloth. We have pleated peplum cloth. But in this tutorial, I want to cut two-step peplum cloth. Flat peplum. Alright. I'm using this Kankara fabric for the half length. I will use this mesh material for the pleat, and I'm using this flame material for the two-step. Alright guys, the first thing I want to do is to cut out my half length using Kankara fabric. The first thing is to fold your fabric into four. My peplum will have zipper at the back, so you will need your zipper allowance. I'm using 1 inch for my zipper allowance. And this is my 1 inch, this is my 1 inch, this is my 1 inch. The zipper side is your open part of your fabric, and the closed part is the front part. So this is how you fold your fabric, your half-length fabric. Alright, then after folding it like this, you will take your half-length measurement and working with 3 inches. Don't forget that we had 1 inch, making 7/8 inch. That 1 inch is very important for the pink allowance. Alright, this is my 17 inches, and we cut it out. So with patches on my breeches, holes in both your shoes, in my coat of many colors.
And for all this, you will follow the bust of your client's measurement. The bust I'm working with is 32. Your 32 divided by 4 plus 2. That's the normal method. I'm having 11 inches, and this is my 11 inches. And I told him all the love my mama sewed.
Follow the client's back. And I told the back of your client divided by 2. Mama the back I'm working with is 6 inches. Divided by 2, I'm having 7.5 inches. Okay, you take your back measurement from this front part, from the front part. And this 7.5 inches. Okay, after that, I will take my next measurement. The next measurement I'm working with is 20 by the side and 5 inches
left.
You can use your French cup, I'm using round. You can use your French cup to cut it, and you can make it. Alright guys, the half hole is 9 inches. Depending on the person you are sewing for, if it is the taller person or the person that is fast, you can use 10 inches. But the person I'm sewing for is the normal 9 inches I'm using for half. Okay, you will take your armhole measurement, that is 9 inches. From this, your half back, you will get the shape of your armhole. You can also use French cuff to cuff it, or you use your hand. Then you come down here for the person band. The band I'm working with is 13 inches divided by 4 plus 2, normal method. I'm having 9.5. You take your, anything you are measuring, you take it from this closed part, that's the front part, not from the side. Okay guys, 9.5, this is my 9.5. You connect it together. You can slant your armhole and you can leave it like that, but I'm slanting by 1/2 inch just to get the shoulder slant. Then my front, the front and the back is same measurement. In some cases, the front might be round while the back might be four corner, but in this tutorial both the front neck and the back neck is round neck. Okay guys, I'm through with my half length. Let me open it and see. This is my front part and this is the back. It's because it's having zipper. Zipper will be in between, and that's for the back. Alright guys, I'm done with my... Okay guys, the next thing I'm cutting is my
flare part. Remember at the beginning of this tutorial, I said that the top I'm sewing, the pattern top I'm sewing, it will have 2-step flare. How will I get my length? You will minus your half length from the full length top. The full length top is 24, while the half length is 16. So 24 minus 16, you will have 8 inches. Alright, the longer part of my peplum is 8 inches. It's because it's having 2 flares. So you reduce it by 2. That's the one peplum will be 8 inches and the second peplum will be 6 inches. Okay guys, I want to cut the longest part for that 8 inches. This is how you will fold your fabric. You first fold like this. I'm folding 240 degree flare, and you do it like this. You can fold like this to cut your peplum. If you fold like this to cut your peplum, it will be fuller. But if you want to manage your fabric, you can fold like this. That's 180 degrees. But I want it to be full, so I'm folding 240 degrees, and this is how you will fold it. After folding it like this, you come to this part. The weight measurement of the person you are working with divided by 4 plus 1. That one is seam allowance. Alright, the weight is 30. 30 divided by 4 plus 1 inch. That is the weight you have. You come here and you measure your 8.5. Okay. This is my 8.5 and you will mark it. This is how to measure your flare. You come here, I have 5.5 here. Then you take it round, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5. You will circle it. Don't forget that the top length I'm working with is 24 inches. Minus 16 inches for the half length. I'm having 8 inches left for the flare. The first part of my flare, the longest part of my flare. Plus 1, that's 9 inches. The longest part of my flare, that's 9 inches. 8 plus 1, 9 inches. And you take your 9 inches round. And you connect them together. And you cut it out. Remember, I'm cutting the first flare, the longer part, and this is the full flare. This is the first one. You will reduce this by 2 inches to get the second flare. That's 6 inches. The same method. You will fold first, fold into two. And you fold into four. I will still follow the same waist measurement. That's 8.5. It's only the length that we reduce by 2 inches. And now we have 6 inches. 5.5, and now we have 6 inches for my length. The same method. The way you cut the first one, that's how you cut the second, the shortest part. The only difference is the length. You reduce it by 2 inches. Join them together and cut it out. Something like this. says the sister. Hey guys, I want to call the last part, which is the sleeve. The length I'm working with for the sleeve is 17 inches plus 1, that's 18 inches. You will mark your 18 inches. I want to cut the two sleeves together. You can cut it separately and you can cut it together. But I'm cutting it together. You will fold it into four like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. I've already folded mine into four. Then you measure the length first. 17 inches is the sleeve I'm working with. I'm cutting to a quarter sleeve. Plus 1, 18. 18, 18. You mark it together and cut it out from the fabric. So this is the sleeve I'm working with. The round top of the sleeve I'm working with is 14 inches. Divided by 2, I have 7 plus 1, that's 8 inches. So this is my 8 inches. And the round down I'm working with is 12 inches. Divided by 2, that's 6 plus 1, 7 inches. Okay, it's not having any pleated sleeve. It's just straight sleeve. I will come here and measure my 4 inches. It depends on the person you are sewing for. This is the normal measurement. If the person is fatter, you will use 5 inches. Or if the person is taller, but the normal measurement is 4 inches. You come here, you measure your 4 inches, and you connect it here. This open part is where you will measure your 4 inches, not this closed part. And you will connect it like this, and connect it to your random to get the shape of your sleeve. You trim it out like this. That's how to cut sleeve or straight sleeve. And you cut here like this. You make sure that you knot here so that when you get to your machine, it will be easy for you. So this is the sleeve, the two pieces of my sleeve. You can see it there. Let me put it like this so that you see what I just cut. You can see this is my sleeve. Alright guys, if you find this tutorial helpful, don't forget to subscribe, like and also comment. See you in my next video. Bye!